In this video, we're going to take a look at what's new with the Notes app and macOS Sequoia with macOS Sequoia. Now, if you find this video helpful, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's take a look at what's new with the Notes app with macOS Sequoia. Let's go over to my Mac. The first tip we're going to look at is collapsible sections. Let's go ahead and open up my Notes app here. Now, this does not require Apple Intelligence. Actually, the first few features I'm going to show you do not require Apple Intelligence at all. So if you have an older Mac, you'll still be able to use some of these features. All right, so I'm going to create a new note. With collapsible sections, what we can do is we can have text hidden or collapse underneath like a topic title. Now, the way that this works is through styles. If you're not familiar with styles, when you go and create a new note, so I have a blank note here, the first sentence that you type in here is going to be the note title. So I just go in here, this is the note title. And it's formatted as a title. And this will come into play once I show you how collapsible sections work, these different styles. So I'm going to hit return here. When you hit return, it now changes into a body text. So this is body text. So this is body text. And then if I keep typing, it's still going to be body text. I'm just going to go line one and line two. All right, so basically what I have here is a title. This is styled as a title. And then I have some text here that is styled as body. So where does this come into play with our collapsible sections? Well, basically, if we change the style of a sentence, so I'm going to go over to where it says this is body text, I click in there and I'm able to change that style. I can change it into a header, I can change it into a title. To do that, all we have to do is just click in there, and then we just go up to the double A's here, and when I click on this, I can go and change the style. So I can change it to a title, heading, or subheading. On any one of those, let's go ahead and change it to a heading. When I select heading here, what it's going to do is it's going to make it a collapsible section. That's all we have to do. So I select this, and then we can see when I move my cursor here, we have this little caret that is pointing down. That means that it is open. So now when I click on this caret here, it closes it. It basically hides that text. So that is what a collapsible section is. You just click on this to show and hide. And all we have to do is just change the style into one of these three styles, title, heading, or subheading. If I make it back into a body text, what it'll do is it'll remove that collapsible section. So that's how collapsible sections work. Another new feature is we can highlight text, basically change the color. We can make it stand out. Again, no Apple Intelligence is required for this. So how do we do that? Well, basically all we have to do is just select the text. So I have this text selected here. And then we just go back up to our double A's. Over on the right, we have these two new tools. The pen, which turns it on and off, and then the color. So I'm going to go click on the color. I can select the color. We're going to go with purple here. And now we can see that that text is highlighted as purple. To remove it, we just select it again. And then we go up to our style, and then we go over to this pen tool, and what it'll do is it'll remove it. So I select this, and now it is no longer purple. So that's how we can highlight our text to make it stand out a little bit. Another new feature is we can record to the Notes app, and then we can have the Notes app transcribe what we're recording. To do that, all we have to do is just record, just start a recording. So I'm going to hit return here a couple times. And if we go up to the little icon here where it looks like audio, when I click on this, what it's going to allow me to do is record an audio. So let's say you have your computer, you're at a lecture, you want to record it. Well, when you click on this, it'll record it and then it'll also transcribe it. So let's go ahead and click on this. And you're going to see over here on the right, we now have a new window. And this is where the recording is going to be. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to read a sentence here. Let's just go ahead and click on record. And then I'm going to read a sentence. Record audio sessions with your note and generate live audio transcriptions. You can search through or combine with other comments, checklists, or documents. When I'm done, I just have to click on the pause here. And then I click on done. So it just recorded that. But being that, I'm using macOS Sequoia, when I click on done here, What it's going to do is it's going to transcribe it. And we can see we have a transcription. To view this transcription here, all we have to do is just double click on it. We have our window that opens up over here on the right, and then you're going to see the transcription. Now, if you want to summarize this, if you do have Apple Intelligence, again, this transcription does not require Apple Intelligence, but if you do want to summarize it, I do have Apple Intelligence on this computer, I can also get a summary of this. So I click on this, and now it's going to use Apple Intelligence to get a summary of that. And then if you want to copy this, you can also do that. So you could paste this text into another document as an example. So that's how we can transcribe audio recordings now, and even summarize them if you do have Apple Intelligence. We also have Math Notes. I'm going to close this. With Math Notes, it's not as elegant as it is on the iPad or iPhone. We can actually write out a formula on the iPad and iPhone. With the Mac, we actually have to type it in. So the one that I've been using is real simple, 2 + 2 = And you're going to see that it came back with 4. I did not type in the 4 there. So we can do math, solve math problems directly in the Notes app. Now, the last thing I want to show you is more on Apple Intelligence. In addition to getting that summary when we use it to transcribe an audio file, we also have various writing tools. What we're able to do is have it proofread our text for us that we type out. We can have it change the tone. We can have it rewrite it for us. So how do we do that? Well, let's go over to this note here. I have some text in there, and what I would like to do is rewrite this. Maybe there's some typos in there, and what I'd like to do is rewrite it or make it more friendly. This is where we can use Apple Intelligence. Now, you do need to have a Mac with Apple Silicon in order for this to work. So I do have a MacBook Pro here that's an M1. So now, to get to my writing tools, all I need to do is just go to the toolbar, and you can see this little icon here. When I click on this little icon, it shows me my writing tools. And from here, I can proofread it. I can also rewrite it. And if I want to change the tone, I can make it more friendly, professional, or concise. I can get a summary, add key points, or create key points, create a list, or insert a table. So let's just go ahead and make this more friendly. I select this, and now it is making it more friendly here. And when it is done, all I have to do is just click on Done, and it'll replace what I had in there with a more friendly version. If I do not want to use it, I can also just go back over to Revert, and it'll revert back. If you want to give Apple feedback on the results of these writing tools, you can do that as well. You just go over here to these thumbs up and thumbs down, and that'll give Apple feedback on it. So that is what is new with the Notes app with macOS Sequoia. Most of the new features do not require Apple Intelligence. So you'll be able to use this even on older Macs, as long as it's using macOS Sequoia. We have collapsible sections. We can highlight text, basically make it stand out with color. We can transcribe live audio. And then we also have Math Notes. In addition to that, if you do have a Mac with Apple Silicon, you can also summarize a recording as well as use writing tools to rewrite your text. So that is what is new with the Notes app with macOS Sequoia. Now, if you found this video helpful, what you may want to do is like the video. You can subscribe to my channel. You can share it with your friends and family. You also may want to check out danstutorials.com. Although I do have over 400 videos on YouTube, I have a lot more on my site, danstutorials.com. So how can you help support my efforts? Well, it is a membership-based site. So when you become a member of my site, I do take out all of the ads for the videos. Also, you get access to my AI assistant, which is modeled after an Apple Genius. And you get access to my classes and webinars, which I hold on a regular basis. In addition to that, you're also helping support a small business. It is just me in a corner office of my house, turned a spare bedroom into a studio. So when you do become a member, you are directly supporting my efforts in creating these. I'm not part of some large organization. Check out Dan's tutorials for more information, and thanks for watching.